भारताची पहिली वित्तमंत्री निर्मला सीतारामनान बिरेस्तारा अर्थसंकल्प सादर केलो. पेट्रोल आणि डिझेलचे दर वाढल्यात. मध्यम वर्गीयांक इन्कम टॅक्सात थाकाय दिल्या, पूण हाचो भार गिरेस्तांक सोसचो पडटलो. पूण त्याच बरोबर स्टार्टअप करप्यांक तशेंच घर आणि इलेक्ट्रीक वाहनां घेवपाक सोदतल्यांक सवलती मेळटल्यो.
केंद्रीय अर्थसंकल्प सादर जाता त्या वेळार मध्यमवर्गीय आयकर सवलतीची आस्त दवरतात. पूण हे खेपे जे कोण घरा बांधपाक सोदतात वा इलेक्ट्रीक वाहनां घेवपाक सोदतात तांकां थकाय दिल्या. पळयात.
We have taken several measures in the past to alleviate the tax burden on small and medium income earners, as those having annual income up to 5 lakhs are not required to pay any income tax. However, in view of the rising income levels, those in the highest income brackets need to contribute more to the nation's development. I therefore propose to enhance the surcharge on individuals having taxable income from 2 crore to 5 crores and 5 crore and above, so that effective tax rates for these two categories will increase by around 3% and 7% respectively. I propose to allow an additional deduction of up to 1,50,000 rupees for interest paid on loans borrowed up to 31st March 2020 next year. For purchase of affordable house valued up to 45 lakhs. Therefore, a person purchasing an affordable house will now get an enhanced interest deduction up to 3.5 lakhs of rupees. This will translate into benefit of 7 lakh of rupees to the middle class home buyers over their loan period of 15 years. Government has already moved the GST council to lower the GST rate on electric vehicles from 12 to 5%. Also, to make electric vehicle affordable to consumers, our government will provide additional income tax deduction of 1.5 lakhs of rupees on the interest paid on loans taken to purchase electric vehicles. You would benefit to the level of 2.5 lakh rupees. At present, startups are not required to justify fair market value of their shares issued to certain investors, including Category 1 alternative investment funds. I propose to extend this benefit to Category 2 alternative investment funds also. At the moment, it's available for AIF Category 1. Now I expand this to include Category 2 AIFs also. Therefore, valuation of shares issued to these funds shall be beyond the scope of income tax scrutiny.
अंदूचे बजेट पेट्रोल आणि डिझेलची महागाई घेऊनच आयला. ताजे साबार परिणामही दिसून येऊ येतात. भांगार आणि हेर मोलाच्या वस्तूंबरोबर इंधनावेली कस्टम ड्युटी 1 रुपयान वाढवल्या. टाईल्स, काजूबियो, गाड्यांचे स्पेअर पार्ट, डिजिटल आणि व्हिडिओ रेकॉर्डर्स तसेच सीसीटीव्ही कॅमेऱ्यांचे दरही वाढू येतात.
कस्टम्स ड्युटी इज बीइंग एक्झेम्प्टेड ऑन सर्टन पार्ट्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक व्हेकल्स. कस्टम्स ड्युटी इज ऑल्सो बीइंग एक्झेम्प्टेड ऑन कॅपिटल गुड्स required for manufacture of specified electronic goods. So the export duty is being rationalized on raw and finished leather. This gives me room to review excise duty and cess on petrol and diesel. I propose to increase special additional excise duty and road and infrastructure cess, each one by 1 rupee a litre on petrol and diesel.
अनिवासी भारतीयांक मात खोशीची खबर. देशात पाऊल दवरतकच पासपोर्ट दाखवल्याबरोबर तांकां आधार कार्ड मेळटली. ह्यान फुडे पॅन कार्ड सक्तीचे आसचे ना. तुमचे आधार कार्ड पॅन कार्डा बरोबर लिंक करतले.
I propose to consider issuing Aadhaar card for non-resident Indians with Indian passports after their arrival in India without waiting for 180 days. I propose to make PAN and Aadhaar interchangeable and allow those who do not have PAN card to file income tax returns by simply quoting their Aadhaar number and also use it wherever they are required to quote the PAN.
गोवा 365 ब्यूरो पणजी।